Dispenser going up.
Guess that'll do.
Hey, Uncle Dane with another video. The footage you'll see in the background is just some pre-recorded stuff. I will be talking over it about a subject that I guess you could consider a callback to the very first commentary I did about 9 months ago called New Wrench Concept. In that video, I threw around an idea for a wrench that could possibly introduce another way to play as a battle engineer besides just using the gunslinger. Since then, Valve has actually more or less addressed the problem of a black and white engineer metagame when it comes to offense versus defense, mainly by changing the speed in which NGs move while hauling and buffing the Jag to be a better offensive wrench in general. So I thought it was time to talk a little bit more about a few things that I'd like to see added to the engineer arsenal to give NGs more variety and balance the metagame a little bit more, because Valve is certainly headed in the right direction based on the gunmetal changes, and I'd be stoked to see that trend actually continue. So enough chit-chat, let's get right down to the first idea for a weapon concept that I had, the Brawn Over Brains PDA. So the engineer's PDA slot is one of the few things in the game that actually doesn't have an unlock, so I think it's time we start looking at those possibilities. My idea for a PDA replacement is a version that has the following stats: plus 25 health, and all sentry guns max level is reduced by 1, and you can't build any mini sentries. So for an example, the way it would work would be like this. If the engineer is using a wrench, he will have 150 base health, but his sentry gun can only be upgraded to level 2, and if he were to use the gunslinger, he will have 175 base health, but he will not be able to build a mini sentry. The reason why I think this PDA would make a great addition and options for engineers is that a battle NG has been pretty two-dimensional for a pretty long while. The only real option you have for a truly flank-heavy shotgun-wielding building man is to use the gunslinger and shotgun, using the extra health to your advantage to get into one-on-one fights. The Brawn Over Brains PDA will promote a lot more diversity for battle engineers. They can choose to have 125 health with a level 3 sentry, 150 health with a mini sentry, 150 health with a level 2 sentry, or 175 health with no sentry and rely solely on their shotgun. This new PDA would pair nicely with the Jag, of course, but it would also make the alternative playstyle of flank engineer while using the Eureka effect a little more viable, since you have 25 more health. Overall, I think a new PDA in general would be really cool, but this idea improves the options for a very important engineer playstyle that I would like to see utilized more often. Moving on to the second weapon concept, this one is a secondary replacement for the engineer that I decided to call the Tesla Taser, or the Einstein EMP, couldn't really decide which. This would be more of a tool than a weapon, and it has the following stats. Fires an electromagnetic pulse that travels up to 360 hammer units, or 20 feet, and it recharges every 10 seconds. Pulse damages sappers on hit, pulse reveals cloak spies for 2 seconds on hit, and the negative aspect is that the pulse does damage to self equal to 50% of your current health. The reasoning behind adding this weapon is mainly that the engineer desperately needs another secondary. Right now we have the pistol, which is generally good in offensive situations, the Wrangler, which is generally good in defensive situations, and the short circuit, which is an underwhelming weapon to use in most situations. Nonetheless, the short circuit provides an answer to a few of the engineer's hard counters, which is projectiles, so why not make a secondary that provides an answer to his mortal enemy, the spy? The main reason why a lot of engineers stay really close to their nest is because if they don't, a sapper can severely ruin their day. Now, I'm of the opinion that an engineer shouldn't be forced to stay close to their buildings at all times. I think that a lot of the stigma surrounding the engineer that says that it's a boring and easy class is because the mere presence of a spy will force an engineer to turtle behind a sentry, so I think that there should be an answer to that. Being able to remove a sapper from a distance would encourage engineers to roam free and allow them to spread their buildings out, which is a very good thing to do in the first place. It prevents everything from getting destroyed by a few mouse clicks of a demo man or a soldier. It also will allow you to passively prevent a spy from pulling off a stab and sap, since you will be too far away to become the victim of their signature two-hit combo. Revealing a cloak spy is another thing that you can use to passively spy check while you have some downtime. That's just a bonus so that you wouldn't have to rely on a pyro to spray everywhere in order to catch out a lurking Frenchman. And the downside, I think, is a fair trade-off, because it can be pretty risky. Cutting your current health in half makes it so that you can only really use the EMP when you have confidence that you can manage a few seconds without a lot of health until you get healed. However, it always takes you down to within range of a one-hit kill from an ambassador headshot, so if a spy is quick enough, they may still be able to take advantage of your low health by resapping the gun and then taking a shot at you from afar. Overall, I think that an EMP has always has been a common request from the community because it would be a pretty cool mechanic, and like I said before, the engineer has an abysmally low number of secondaries to choose from right now. So anyway, on to the last weapon concept that I have for you guys today. This one's a little different in that it actually is not for the engineer at all, it's for the heavy weapons guy. I know, I lied. But even though it's not equipped by the engineer, its design actually assists fellow NGs greatly. This is a secondary replacement that I've named the Ammo Reserve. The idea is borrowing heavily from the concept surrounding the sandwich and his other food items, except this is not food. This is ammo. Specifically, the stats are as follows. When used, replenishes all ammo supply up to 300, can be thrown with mouse 2 to provide a medium ammo pack, recharges in 30 seconds, although it can be overrode by picking up any ammo pack at full ammo, and while active, can see the current metal capacity of friendly engineers while placing the crosshair on them. The reasoning behind this sandwich alternative is to support the engineer in a way that no one else can without killing themselves at his feet. It can also be used to grant engineers more metal by picking up small ammo packs to recharge the timer, making for some next level teamwork setup strats. I could also mention that it has natural synergy with the Hulong heater, which is arguably one of the worst miniguns right now, simply because it eats up so much ammo, and the ammo reserve would help negate that downside a little bit. I added the passive ability to know the ammo capacity of a friendly engineer while bringing it active because it would make for easier non-verbal teamwork if the heavy was aware that the engineer needed more metal without having to actually ask. I also like how it stays true to the lore surrounding the heavy weapons guy. I mean, he is an expert on heavy weapons, and his obsession with bullets fits well with keeping a backup ammo box handy. So before I wrap up this idea and the video, I thought I should also mention that just because it's a replacement for the sandwich doesn't mean he will be eating the ammo box. I imagined the animation would be him unpacking it and unloading the ammo into his gun. So yeah, to summarize this video, I think that snowballing weapon concepts and theory crafting what could be the next cool unlock it's a lot of fun, but in the end, it's all up to Valve, so I guess we should just wait and see what they do. That being said, I do have high hopes for the future of weapon additions, and putting ideas out there is a great way to get excited for things to come. So thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed the video, and let me know what you personally think of the concepts that I had for new weapons. Are they unbalanced? Are they not impactful enough? Do you think that they'd actually use any of these? I'd love to hear what you think. And also, if you have a creative idea for a new weapon, tell me about it. I really love reading that stuff. And always, as always, thank you for watching. Talk to your nieces and nephews next time. Bye-bye.